too many people who can command the respect of our next guest, and he has plenty of it inside the boxing ring, despite the fact that he's never even thrown a punch. His words have become one of the most famous war cries in the sporting world. Here it is.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Those five little words have made our next guest a lot of money and brought him a lot of fame over the years. Please welcome the ring announcer to rule them all, Michael Buffett, Studio 10. Hello.
Hi. I think I just saw myself age 30 years over those three clips.
Oh, no. Thank you so much for joining us. The Courier Mail describes you as the silky voice of a savage sport.
Wow,
so how did those five words come to you?
You know, one of the most exciting parts of the fight is the ring walks and the entrances. And the fighters come to the ring with all that music. And what was happening years ago, the announcers would then introduce all their buddies with the commission, the chairman, the commissioners, the board members, the referee, the three judges, four doctors. And you've just killed all that energy and excitement in the room. So I wanted a hook that would let the fans know they're about to meet the stars of the show, the fighters. And I tried, man your battle stations and fasten your seat belts, but the great Muhammad Ali used to say he was ready to rumble, and I kind of incorporated that into the saying that you hear now with let's get ready to rumble.
Yeah.
And what a hook. I think it's so famous it's actually been copyrighted. But Michael, tell us about your own background, because you had a really interesting childhood, didn't you? You're actually fostered out.
Well, I was, from the age of 11 months, I went to live with the people that raised me until the day I went to the Army at age 20. So I had a great family and family surroundings with the people I referred to as mom and dad. I always knew my real mother, but I never met my biological father until I was in my late 40s.
Oh, wow. Your brother's been a very important part of building your empire. He helped you with establishing that rumble line and making the most of it. And you also worked as the exclusive commentator for the Trump-controlled casinos. And Trump reckoned you were great and very unique. What is Trump like?
I think we all know what Trump is like. What else can I say?
Yeah, but I mean, you had dealings with him. I've never had dealings with him.
Person to person, he has a great personality. He's very friendly. He's very charming. And that's the way I knew him back in the late 80s. And I was sort of like blessed to have him mandate that for all the fights at his hotel casinos, that the promoter had to use my services. So that was a great break for me.
Yeah, I didn't realize you had boxing matches at casinos. So it was really interesting for me to read that about you.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Oh, yeah.
Michael, do you use any other catchphrases when you're working?
No, Let's Get Ready to Rumble has morphed into some other phrases, like for basketball, Let's Get Ready for Round Ball. I have also have a registered trademark for Let's Get Ready to Crumble, which I used once on a New Year's Eve about 20 years ago in Las Vegas. We did a TV special and I said, let's get ready to crumble. And then they blew the hotel up and then built another one a few years later. So I trademarked that phrase, and it came in handy a few years later when a big time cheese company wanted to use it in a commercial.
Oh, good.
Oh, well done. Now, Michael, you've got the most beautiful sounding voice. Is there anything that you do to look after it in particular?
Well, it's a matter of luck. You just have to try to stay healthy. I do have a special throat tea that I like to travel with and keep with me if I ever feel my throat irritated. But, you know, just stay healthy, gargle with salt water, take vitamin C.
You are a very handsome man, Michael. You have terrific bone structure. You've never thrown a punch inside the ring. Is that part of the reason why you don't want to muck up that lovely face of yours?
Well, I like to say that I'm the only person in the history of boxing to have been in the ring with Mike Tyson, Evander Holyfield, Marvelous Marvin Hagler, Manny Pacquiao, and none of them ever laid a glove on me. That's because after I introduce them, I get the heck out of the ring.
Don't touch the face. Now, Michael Buffer will be in the ring to announce a huge, huge bout that is happening right here in Australia very soon.
Manny Pacquiao and Jeff Horn. It is going to be massive. It is all anyone in Brisbane is talking about. It is an absolute global event, and it's going to be beyond big.
Well, you can see it on July 2nd at 11 a.m. live. That's exclusive on Foxtel's main event. Michael Buffer, you're a gentleman. Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, thanks for having me. It was great.